Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here. I will be presenting our undergraduate project, SIMPLE, a simplified extensible programming language to facilitate programming in native language for beginners. This project was supervised by Dr. Sukumaran Raghavan of the Faculty of Information Technology and conducted by 14 members of the same faculty, myself included. This is a brief overview of what we will be discussing today, and with that, let's get started. In Sri Lanka, there is currently no appropriate learning environment to support computer programming education. This is largely due to the complexity of general purpose programming languages such as C, Java, and Python, which novices are introduced to, as well as the language barrier that exists, since major programming languages, their resources and documentations are mostly in English. This also leads to a gap in the current school curriculum, as well as a knowledge gap that exists when shifting from school level programming language education to university level. These observations were gathered from analyzing existing introductory level programming languages, where we identified two main language representations. Basically, the visual or block-based representation, including languages such as Alice, Scratch, and Microbit, and text-based languages such as Cojo, Loco, and OZ. Visual languages have usually drag-and-drop interfaces with large graphical components. In comparison, text-based languages do not have these specific interfaces and focus more on providing that coding exposure. In terms of the programming language, both representations provide basic programming concepts and constructs. The visual grammar is usually represented by blocks and properties of different shapes and colors. The short and concise keywords are to enable translatability and to eliminate syntax and type errors. Text-based languages have syntax that is based on symbols and keywords, and the short and concise keywords are to avoid syntax overhead. Syntax and comparators are also displayed. In terms of language extensibility or translatability, the most extensive translations are for visual languages, while there is almost no translation capability for text-based languages at the moment. I should mention that there is no singular-based translations to either of these two components. With that in mind, our aim is to develop a simplified programming language that could support beginners to computer programming and learning basic concepts by using native language. And our objectives have been implemented in our solution, the Simply Programming Language and Ecosystem. Now, our system has four main components: the Simply Language, Transpiler, Language Mapper, and Platform. The language itself is going to be a text-based programming language with short and simple keywords and syntax patterns designed for increased readability. The error messages have two segments, as technical and descriptive, coming with the error codes and simple and meaningful messages. The simpler programs are usually transpiled into Java and then executed, and this is done through a simple transpiler. The language mapper is responsible for the translation capabilities for both syntax and error mapping. And it's also the component that allows us to provide the first thing in this programming language. The platform comes with a coding playground, which allows users to learn, practice, and compete using our designated programming language, and a visualizer, which is a program animation tool that provides runtime data. A user will usually interact with our simple language via the coding playground or the web-based platform through code submissions. If it's an English simple code, it will be then sent to the transpiler to be transpiled. And the relevant result or error messages will be returned. A native language simple code will first be converted to English via the language mapper's delocalizer before being transpiled. If a user wishes to view the native language version of an English simple code, they must again send it to the mapper or the localizer component of the mapper, where it will return the relevant English simple code. The relevant native language simple code. And any transpiled code can be sent to the visualizer to obtain runtime data information as well. For the design purpose of our language, we conducted several pre-surveys. The first service goal was to identify the difficulties regarding introductory programming concepts and to collect the relevant English keywords. The second was to collect the opinions of difficulty regarding native language coding and to collect single-use keywords. Both surveys targeted two different audience groups, as ICT teachers and first-year undergrads who simulated the behavior of novices. From these surveys, we gathered the finalized English and synchronous keywords, as well as identified that loops, function variables, and keyboard inputs and library inputs were the concepts that required the most attention during the design phase. A positive opinion was also gathered towards native language coding, documentation, and learning from both groups. Here we have a list of all the English and synchronous keywords. There are a total of 28 finalized keywords, and we will be seeing more of this and syntax patterns as well as error messages during the demonstration. The transpiler was also developed in two phases, with syntax and lexical analysis coming in precedence and followed by semantic analysis and target code generation. The mapper also follows two processes as localization and delocalization, which I mentioned briefly earlier. The visualizer works with the transpiled Java code to obtain runtime debugging information, which will then be sent into the visualizer to provide a visual representation. The coding playground is the interface between the simple programming language and the users. The implemented system was then evaluated finally in the form of controlled experiments. Introductory sessions were conducted for the participants via Zoom, and evaluation was carried out through coding exercises and post-evaluation surveys. The language was tested for the effectiveness of using simplified programming language, and the control group was taught using Java, and the experimental group was exposed to simple English, and they were asked to answer a series of coding exercises based on this knowledge. A similar experiment was conducted for testing the effectiveness of native language coding, where the control group was asked to answer in simple English and the experimental group in simple single. Both groups had similar levels of English proficiency to prevent any unwanted influences. The visualizer was demonstrated in comparison with similar tools such as Scratch and Python Tutor, and the results were gathered through post-evaluation surveys. All relevant documentation and coding exercises were provided to students in either English or Simla based on the experiment that they were participating in, and marking was done according to a designated grading rubric, which evaluated the results based on their accuracy, relevance, and overall performance of their answer. In terms of the results, we were able to obtain that the experimental group performed better in both the language and native language tests. The students also perceived that the combination of Scratch and Simple would work well with middle school students, and that Simple should be used as an introductory programming language for the advanced or undergraduate level. Based on these observations, we were able to conclude that a text-based language with simplified keywords, syntax patterns, and simple error messages, combined with native language learning and coding capabilities, with visual aiding tools, would positively impact the productivity of learning carried out by novice programmers. We also have several publications related to this project. Our paper titled Systematic Mapping of Introductory Programming Languages for Novice Learners has been published in Volume 9 of the Early Access Journal. And the paper titled Simply Translate Simplified Approach to Simla-based Coding and Introductory Programming Language Localization is to be published at the 16th IEEE International Conference on Industrial Information Systems next month. This project was also presented at the 2021 National Social Youth Innovation Camp. As further work, we hope to develop other external Wikipedia tools as well as to conduct a more thorough evaluation of the entire system. These are a list of our references, and with that, we will move into a short demonstration. As you can see, this is our dashboard for the Simply web-based platform and ecosystem. We have several components of learn, practice, and compete. And with this, I will move straight into one of our example questions. So here we have one of our example questions, and I'll be using an example code. Now, this is not the answer to this particular question at all, but I'll be using it to just explain a bit of our Simply programming language structure. The main component of Simply program is a function, and we have one main function, which is the starting point of any program. And here we have some integers or some data types and basic if structure, as well as a basic loop structure. Now, let me show you what this would look like in Simla as well. As you can see, there are some letters and names left in English, so we will not be translating any identifiers. This is for the sole purpose of maintaining the reference point between English code and the translated native code so that students may be able to better compare the two. Translating this back to English, I would like to show you a demonstrated error message as well. Let me just change this to string. Right. If I translate this back, you'll see that it's translated as accordingly. And let me just run this code. So we're getting a compiler of this particular code, and here you can see what the standard error would look like. Since I compiled the code, submitted the code in Simla, I'm getting a similar error message as well as an English counterpart. Now this message you can see is a simplified one, and it could have been in English if I had submitted an English code. With this, I would like to move into our Simply Visualizer component. I'll be using the same example code to show you how the visualizer works. Right. So this is our visualization component, and I've set the visualization to start automatically line by line, but it can be controlled manually as well. We have some notes here that can help students to identify what's happening in the process and basically where to look and what concepts are being displayed at the moment. And with that, I can conclude my presentation. Thank you for your time.